Hey, welcome or welcome back. Today we're checking out episode 7 from season 1 of The Last of Us, Left Behind. Now, thoughts on the last episode are on the back half of there. Obviously, it ended with Joel's grievous injury and Ellie kind of flipping her shit, not knowing what to do with the situation. You know, you're a 14-year-old girl, this man fell off the horse, he can't move, how do you move him? What do you do? He's bleeding. Are there people coming after you? But besides that, you know, the couple they met in the beginning of the episode, they lived, you know, Maria and Tommy and everyone at Jackson lived, you know, so, you know, Joel taking a baseball bat, broken bat as a shank. What a messed up wound that's going to be. It was emotional, it had moments, but there were not a lot of dire moments, not a lot of outside threat until the very end. And with this episode being called Left Behind, it's obviously gonna, you know, this has gotta be the Riley episode, and again, I am going to be making game references and changes and things different, because that's, since I know what's gonna happen, any reaction or commentary I have is going to be based around how it happened. So that's what I expect. I don't know if we'll be completely in the past with Riley and Ellie, or a little bit in the present, or if it'll bounce around. I don't know, but I'm curious. It's Sunday night, this just came out, and I'm looking forward to it. I've done a lot of recording this weekend. HBO usually doesn't do me wrong, so without any more stalling, yeah, let's get into it. Season 1, Episode 7, Left Behind. Here we go. Okay, we got some blood drag marks, it looks like. Yeah, that was a funny thing for the game. She parked the horse in the garage. It makes sense.
Leave.
Shut up, Joel.
Take the gun.
Joel, shut the fuck up!
I'm baffled by him being conscious and them having conversation, and it being like this!
Pick up your pace. She's not here anymore, is she?
So things got harder for Ellie after Riley left. Prax! Fucking Prax Meng from the Expanse, right?
Bethany started it.
Well, Bethany's in the infirmary with 15 stitches.
Good.
Okay.
Just put me in the fucking hole.
I put you in the hole 3 times. It doesn't work. There's the other path. You swallow this pride of yours. You follow the rules, you become an officer. You get to tell the Bethanys of the world exactly where to shove it.
You had me at air conditioning and heating, but
I care because no matter what anyone out there says or thinks, we're the only thing holding this all together. If we go down, the people in this zone will starve or murder each other, that much I know.
Someone will become a warlord, a tyrant. There's significance there, but I believe that's to be revealed later on. No pun intended. This otter be good? God damn it! Yeah, look at all the space shit she has on the wall. Good for her. I got the James Webb Space Telescope right there. What up, boy? This whole episode is just going to be a lot of me smirking and grinning like a dumb asshole because I can't say anything.
Shit, you're supposed to, I don't know, talk to your best friend about it.
I joined the Fireflies.
Oh, fuck you.
Come with me for a few hours and have the best night of your life.
And you're dead. Story over.
Wow. Look at how that water trickles down those rusty mailboxes.
I'm surprised they don't have like a red cap filter, something you can put on the light so you can see immediately in front of you without having this bright ass glare that people can see through the windows.
Oh shit.
Fucking Rick Grimes? Who is that?
Yeah.
Is this the big surprise?
No, this guy wasn't here yesterday.
This guy must have spent every card he had to get this.
No one told him he couldn't mix pills with that shit?
That'll do it, man.
I think you knew what I was doing.
What is this, Breaking Bad right now? Did the tub dissolve too?
Yum.
Uh-huh, gimme.
Okay.
It's great.
She likes that more than Joel's, though.
Give me your gun.
All right, fine.
Bad idea. You've been drinking, you just didn't clear it first. Is that a 1911? Is that a 45? I didn't get a good look at it.
In a way, Fedra kind of holds everything together.
Oh!
The mall?
Yeah.
You out of your fucking mind? They sealed that place off for a reason. It's full of infected.
Makes you wonder, if it is safe in there, then why hasn't Fedra, like, went in there on their own and looted it and, you know, taken everything already? Why just close up and be like, yeah, forget about it. Not worth it.
You're gonna go through there, then turn right, you see a door, go through it, wait.
No.
Fucking turn right, open the door, tell me when you're there. Go.
New place to check out! Wouldn't that be seen from the outside, though? Isn't there some sort of roof, or is it all dirty and sooted up or some shit?
Tonight, I'm gonna show you the four wonders of the mall.
You plan stuff?
Electric stairs? Escalator.
Escalator?
She's gonna feel like she's in the Jetsons or something.
No way.
Yeah!
Check me out, man!
Or that shit.
Who are they dunking on? Oh, Victoria's Secret.
I wanted all this stuff.
Do you need me to explain it to you?
Haha, no. I know why.
Oh, making herself, prettied up in the reflection a little bit.
Open your eyes.
Very subtle, things going on here. This was one of them for sure.
Shit. What?
Nothing.
You're drunk.
No.
Yes.
Not yet.
This is nice, because in the game, Ellie got on, and then Riley jumped on, and then it immediately broke down, so they're actually getting to enjoy this. And now they're drinking and driving, apparently, with this machinery.
No.
Oh, come on.
It suffered the same fate. Wait. Ripped to the machinery.
You know, we could make things better. We could be running things.
You could be running things. Standing guard while people shovel shit. That's what they think of me.
I wonder if they'll do the Halloween store.
Please insert $5. Oh, fuck you.
Well, look at that. I came prepared. Back to back?
Yeah. Just scary, just scary. Okay.
Straight out of the game, too, man. This is wild. In a way too cute sort of way. What? They actually get the photos?
Not bad.
The printer is broken in the game. This is ridiculous.
It?
Good for them. It's not going to develop much further, and that's all you get. Oh, no. The arcade. I didn't even think about that. Yo!
Riley, this is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Like, really? What could beat this? The games are on. She doesn't have to make-believe a fucking fight scene. You just have it open? Oh, I'm living here. Yes!
Yeah.
Liu Kang, Cao, Kung Lao, fucking Melina Katana,
fuck yeah.
Scorpion, Sub-Zero Reptile, Johnny Cage,
Deadpool.
Raiden.
But then you wouldn't get to see this.
She knows a fatality. She's really doing it! That's how Ellie knew about it. She wasn't just told about it. She saw it at the arcade. That's crazy. Fucking doll store. Can you think of a creepier place to do this? Well, well, well. Almost had an awkward first kiss to a Mortal Kombat 2 fatality.
Is it in your shirt? Nope. Is it a water pistol?
Better.
That's what I thought they were gonna have the Super Soaker fight.
Volume 2.
Shut up! You made a second one? Where did you get that? Okay, how does a computer get drunk? It takes screenshots.
What are screenshots?
They shouldn't understand that. That's good attention to detail. That's good. Fucking pipe bombs? What are you doing here, Riley?
Did you make these? None of this shit was even about me!
Would you stop?
Fuck you!
Ellie! Ellie, I'm leaving!
But Marlene said no.
Who the fuck is Marlene?
Marlene is the lady that helped me get... It doesn't matter.
Then when Marlene intros herself to Ellie later on, she'll recall this moment.
Tonight's my last night in Boston. And I wanted to say goodbye. This isn't easy, Ellie.
It actually is. You just did it.
The camera angles helped with the intensity because Riley was to the left of the screen looking left and Ellie was to the right of the screen looking right, so it like lessened the distance between them cinematically without having them in the same frame.
Riley? What the fuck?
They are doing the Halloween store. I am so excited.
And you give me this night. This amazing fucking night. And now you're leaving again.
You don't know what it was like to have a family. To belong. Maybe the Fireflies aren't what I think they are, but they chose me.
An interesting idea, not having something ever versus having lost it, you know. A desolation versus an actual loss, a felt loss. Different types of pain, very interesting.
One last thing.
Brick fucking master! I know they're not doing the brick quest, but that would be cool. The same masks that they had in game, this is ridiculous. Same song they played too. How thick is that glass? I'm really afraid for them, you know? Every time they show it, it's really wobbly to me.
What?
I'm sorry.
For what?
Keeping it to the source material. Which is good, and it's about to be very bad. Haven't seen a bite yet. Woo! God damn, that's right. Switchblade to the dome. Oh, I was looking for blood. I didn't see anything.
No!
Fuck. It's starting to hit me now. Like I've had my guard up this whole time. But after Sarah and Tess and Bill and Frank and fucking Sam and Henry, and immense loss is a common theme in this show. Stuff over there.
There's more stuff over there.
They're doing it, man.
Option two. Whether it's 2 minutes or 2 days, we don't give that up.
Just think, if they would have killed themselves, and there wouldn't have ever been even known about a mutation of a potential immunity and cure. This one conversation they're having, this one moment, this one choice, is the only reason why any of it exists. And why Ellie's so determined to see it through. Even if she stitches him up, the next time we see him, he's not going to be doing much better. At least try to get the needle bent a little bit. Yeah, but if he has internal bleeding, you're not doing anything for that. He's still gonna swell up and bloat up and get sick. Damn. I like it. Whew! Alright, let's get to the outro. Ellie now stuck surging on her own. Am I reading that right? Yeah. Ellie now stuck surging on her own and now being forced to take... Is this a real... This is written weird, guys. Ellie now stuck surging on her own and now being forced to take care of somebody she loves deeply reflects on past events in her life. That sounds like a synopsis, not a description. But sure. Yeah, so the whole episode was based on the Left Behind DLC, but it just stayed on the her and Riley stuff, which I think worked. You know, I like having Ellie and Joel get to a household and get situated, but then the whole bread and butter of this is her interaction with Riley and how it ended off with them and what it meant and means for Ellie on her journey. And then at the end of the episode, you know, we get her performing the surgery on Joel, trying to stitch him back together. So this was episode 7. I'm pretty sure there are 9. So I don't know how long 8 is going to be, or what happens in 8 is going to linger into 9 and then 9, you know. I wonder how they're going to do this. I really do. There's 2 big set elements left, but I almost feel like the next one is too big for one episode, is what I'm trying to say. I got tight, but I held it in there. kept it together. What usually happens with this show is I'll watch a reaction to somebody of it later on, and then when they cry, then I cry, you know. So I'm not just getting through this and then I'm fine, or sometimes in the edit things catch me. Alright, I think that's going to do it for me for now. I hope this was worth your time, and invite you to please join me for the rest of the season. Only 2 more to go, and I'm sure it's going to be great. Thanks again for being here, and goodbye.